In this session, we'll go a little further with the GafferThree node. So we'll take a look at various light workflows, so the use of master materials, rigs, environment lights, and we'll finish off by making the use of the linking tab within the GafferThree parameters. So I'll first create a bounce light for the back of our environment, and then I'm going to create an area light and start moving this around. So I'm just going to get it to a position. I'm going to send off a quick live render. Okay. So now that we have a rough position, I'm going to right click over here and select Add Master Material. So what this will have is a material parameter, but it won't have an object or linking parameter. So I'm just going to add shader, add a light shader, and area light. So now I can start manipulating these values. So I'm going to make this color roughly intensity. I'm going to bump it up. And so now if I want to apply this master material to my area light, what I can do is double click over here and then select my master material. And so now this light is bound to my master material. So if my master material changes, this light will pick up these values. Now I'm just going to duplicate this area light a few times, and I'm going to transform them across. So roughly like this, and there we go. So now I'm going to create a rig. So I'm going to add a rig, and now what you can do is select all of your lights and then drop this down within my rig. So you can see this white bar gets shorter when you're dropping the lights underneath the rig. Now if I drop these down over here, we have a pivot point for these three lights. So if I start transforming my rig, it'll transform my lights with it. Now I can scale these a little bit across this way. So now these three lights are all inheriting the material parameters from this master material. Next, I'll move on to environment lights. So I'm going to right click, add 3D lights, and environment light. So if you have an HDR array, you can search for its path over here. However, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to set the color to a bright blue, and then I'm going to reduce the intensity down to quite a low value. So I'm really just using this to lift up the image. So next I'm going to show you how you can work with the linking tab in your light's parameters. So I'm going to make yet another light. I want to keep this environment light outside of my rig. There we go. And I'm going to add an area light. And I'm going to call this rim light. And I'm actually going to rename this also bounce light. I'm just going to copy those over here. There we go. So with this light, I'm going to have it light the back of the mug. I'm just going to lift this up, rotate that around, bring that down. So I'm going to set the color to a light blue, the intensity to increase that a little bit. So you can see this light is acting on the ground. So what I can do is disable this light for the ground geometry. So stop this light from acting on it. So what I can do is go into my linking tab, and you can see you have light linking parameters and shadow linking parameters. And what really interests us, if we don't want our light to impact our ground, is to just middle mouse button drag our ground shape over to our statements. Oh dear. Okay, that just needed to be set off again. So now you can see that the light isn't acting on the ground anymore. So I'm lastly going to show you how you can start working with multiple GafferThree nodes. If you're iterating your lighting, you can create another GafferThree. So I'm just going to hit GafferThree and I'm going to place this underneath our first GafferThree node. And you can see that this is empty. But what you can do is if you toggle this little icon over here and show incoming scene, then it will show you all the lights that exist within your scene. So what I want to do is, let's say, just edit this one. So you right click it and select adopt for editing. And then you can change any parameter you want. So here I'm just going to change this light, make it bright. There we go. I'll just make it bright yellow. So you can see that this little box over here will indicate that that parameter has been changed locally. So if you want to revert back to its previous value, so the value that was set in the first GafferThree, then you can just hit this box over here. So this is a way in which you can iterate your work. If you want to test various lighting setups, then you can basically layer up your GafferThree nodes. And if you want to revert back to a previous version, then you can just remove them or save it out. So if I delete this, the way you can save out any part of your light setup is by right-clicking and export rig. So you can export pretty much anything you want within the GafferThree node that way, and you can transfer your nodes across. So this is it for this session. I hope this clip was useful. Please let me know if there's anything in particular you'd like to see. So in the next episode, we'll clean up the node graph. So use backdrops and colors to make it a bit more readable.